Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Today I like to thank all my subscribers all over the world for subscribing me and making my YouTube channel Marine Tech Hub to the highest level. So I would like to tell a little bit more about my channel. I have been running this channel for the last 5 years. Last 4 years the channel was free. Now I have come to a level where I got the membership. So membership level 1, 2, 3, the level membership 5, which is ₹3999. In this channel where I will be giving you all the videos for 1 year, plus I will be helping you for all the troubleshooting at real time from anywhere. So lot of superintendents, chief engineers and all engineers are calling me for troubleshooting. I am very happy. It was my dream that I should have a channel like this where I will be able to help people and shipping companies to save time and money. So you can always choose whichever membership you want, but level 5 I will give you all the help, and online training I'm giving you online training for ₹1499. Plus, if you want to subscribe, you can pay me. The bank details are here. If you want to pay through bank, and you can, if you want to pay through Paytm, you can scan the QR code. So I'll very much thankful to all the subscribers again, and have a nice day. Thank you. Today I'll be explaining you about the CO2 fire extinguisher system. In this picture you can see there is a fire in the emergency generator room, and how you are going to activate the CO2 I'll be telling you about that. Once you open the room, you can see this is the emergency generator. We got the fuel tank. This is a quick closing valve. So there is a fire in this room, so I will close the quick closing valve from outside by pulling the wire from outside, then closing the dampers so that no oxygen is coming inside. We got the release cabinet for releasing the CO2. All the instructions are given here. Take this key and open the cabinet. Once you open the cabinet, all the instructions are given over here, but I will be explaining you. Once you open the cabinet, we got two cylinders, cylinder number 1 and cylinder number 2. What we are going to do is initially open cylinder number 1 and see the pressure here. It should be more than 30 bar. If it is less, you open the other cylinder. So you get 30 bar here. Once you have 30 bar, then pull down the valve handle down. This will make the main valve to open. Once that is open, then push the interlock cover on the other side. Then open this valve. This is cylinder number 2. Once this is open, then pull down the lever number 2 down. Once this is down, this will open the main CO2 bottles, and the CO2 will be released into the compartment. In 85% of it will be released in 2 minutes. So the list of these CO2s for each of the compartment: engine control room, purifier room, chemical room, garbage, paint locker, emergency generator room, we have got 2 bottles. This is the CO2 bottle room. We have got all the bottles over here, and when you are operating the first cylinder number 1, we are opening the main valve here. So once the main valve is open, gas comes on the pneumatic cylinder here and opens this. We have got delay, pneumatic delay of 30 to 40 seconds for each of the room. Like engine control room, we got 10 bottles. The delay for 30 to 40 seconds is there in order to escape people, to escape from the place. So that's why the delay is there. In case if you don't want the delay, in that case you can manually operate this valve so that the CO2 bottles will be released. So all these bottles, you can see this is for the engine control room, this is for the purifier room, then we have got for garbage room here, then paint locker, then you got the generator room here, chemical. We got all the 6 bottles for different rooms. In case you want to release it manually, the bottles, you have got the handles, take it and operate the CO2 bottles. This is the delay of 30 to 40 seconds which I am talking about. And the pressure of CO2 is released, you can see it on the pressure gauge. We got safety valves for each of the room here. In case the pressure is more, the safety valve will lift. So this is the cylinder where the gas will come, and cylinder number 1 is activated. The gas will push the piston and open the main valve over here. We have got hoses for which we can connect it over here, air hose, so that connect it to this point and test the lines for any blockage. If you have any doubt regarding this, I will be explaining you in more details. Thank you. This is the CO2 release cabinet. We got the cylinder number 1 here. First we open this valve. Once you open, see the pressure is more than 30 bar, otherwise open the other cylinder number 2. Once it's more than 30 bar, then operate this lever down to open the main valve. Then push the interlock this side, then open this valve, cylinder number 2, then operate this second lever which will release the CO2. I will run the video for you. What we am doing is, I am opening the first cylinder here, seeing the pressure, operating the first cylinder number 1 for main valve, push the interlock, then open the cylinder number 2, see the pressure is already there, operate this, this will able to release the CO2 into the room.